Forage are the small organisms that feed bigger organisms. The small fishes that often are seen schooling near the surface in Chesapeake Bay. And sometimes you see big flocks of birds feeding on these fish, and oftentimes predator fish under the schools driving them to the surface. That's what you would seek out when you try to find striped bass and bluefish, is the bait fish. There are a number of small fishes that are important that serve as forage.
There's a menhaden.
Look at that.
The Atlantic menhaden, the bay anchovy, those are the two that are most prominent. But it's not only fish that are important forage.
CHESMAP stands for the Chesapeake Bay Multi-Species Monitoring and Assessment Program. And really the main objectives of the survey are to get a handle on the abundances of all the different fishes and invertebrates that are inhabiting the bay. We also remove stomachs from these specimens. We'll bring those back to the lab and quantify those. And that really is to give us a handle on the interactions amongst the different fishes and invertebrates in the bay. Really, the main way you can quantify interactions right now is by seeing who eats what and in what quantities.
When we looked at the diets of benthic, meaning fish that feed on the bottom, worms, bivalves, which means clam-like organisms, snail-like organisms, and also a crustacean called a mycid, which an opossum shrimp is the common name, turned out to be among the most important forage species. The bay anchovy is a little fish. It seldom grows to more than 3 or 4 inches in length, only lives 2 or 3 years maximum lifespan, but it's the most abundant fish in Chesapeake Bay. It's the most abundant fish on the east coast of North America. The Atlantic menhaden also is important. It's a bigger fish. It can grow to 8 or 10 inches in length or more. We're worried about water quality. Too much nutrient pollution in Chesapeake Bay. Too much nitrogen and phosphorus. In addition to maintaining good water quality, maintaining good habitat is important. Hardening of shorelines, putting riprap and other kinds of structures in place on the shoreline. These are effective in perhaps stopping erosion of the shorelines that people also, of course, are very concerned about, but they also diminish the productive capacity of the shallow water areas of the bay. Some forage fishes are harvested in the bay. More than 50,000 tons of Atlantic menhaden have been caught annually for many years. Many people believe that the resource is in better shape than it has been in the past few decades. We still need to be concerned about the management of this resource because of its potential to be over-harvested and to affect both predator fishes and also lots of seabirds. For example, ospreys and eagles. We need to be concerned about conserving the ability of the bay to feed most of the key predators that depend on it.